हेलो क्लास 11th स्टूडेंट, टुडे अगेन आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट चैप्टर 5। टॉपिक इज थियोरी ऑफ डिमांड, दिस इज पार्ट 4th। इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो आई हैड टोल्ड यू अबाउट इंडिविजुअल डिमांड फंक्शन। विद इन दैट वी हैड लर्न अबाउट ऑल दीज फैक्ट। ओके, सो हियर सॉरी, इंडिविजुअल डिमांड फंक्शन इज गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन दैट डिमांड ऑफ एक्स कमोडिटी इज डिपेंड अपॉन प्राइस ऑफ एक्स, प्राइस ऑफ रिलेटेड गुड, इनकम, टेस्ट एंड प्रेफरेंस ऑफ बायर एंड एक्सपेक्टेड चेंज इन प्राइस। सो इन दिस वे इंडिविजुअल मीन्स वॉट? इंडिविजुअल, आई हैड टोल्ड यू, इंडिविजुअल मीन्स one buyer, individual means one buyer. Okay, so in this way the demand of x good of one buyer is influenced by these factor. Okay, so I had told you, let me understand. Okay, so individual demand function. So demand of x is the function of price of x, price of related good, income, test and preference, and expected change in price. So these are the factors that influence the demand of a particular buyer. Okay, let me make a quick revision. Okay, demand of x and price of x both are related negatively. If price of x will increase in response, demand of x is going to decrease. Take the example of onion. If the price of onion is going to 200 per kg, so you are going to demand less onion. If it is available 20 rupees per unit, so you will purchase more. So in this way there is negative relation. Okay, now talk about next, price of related good. Price of related good, we are going to discuss about price of one good and demand of other good. Okay, so here we are going to discuss about ki if price of x good, here we find positive relation. Okay, if price of x is going to increase, in response demand of x good is going to decrease. Okay student, and demand of other good yani related good is going to increase. For example, you can take the example of tea and coffee. Okay, so if price of tea is going to increase, in response demand of tea is going to decrease, and in response demand of coffee is going to be high. Yani people started to drink coffee in place of tea. So this is what, this is substitution effect that we find in price of related good in case of substitute good. Okay, what is substitute goods? Substitute goods are those goods which can be used in place of each other. Okay, now when we are discussing price of related good, so always it is explained in concern of two. Substitute good, there we find positive relation. Okay, and second is complementary good. Complementary goods means used together. When two goods are used together to satisfy one want, like if you want to go somewhere, so you require bike as well as petrol in the bike. Okay, so these are the complementary good. Okay, so here we find negative relation between what? Between price of one good and demand of related good. Here we find negative relation. It's mean ki if price of x good is going to increase in response, demand of x good is going to decrease, and demand of related good yani ki y good is going to be decreased. Why? Because this x and y, like you can take the example of bike and petrol, both are demanded together. So when there will be less use of bike, it's mean there will be less use of petrol. Okay, so there we find negative relation, yani price of one good या price of x good is going to decrease, in response the price of related good यानि कि complementary good is going to be decreased. So in simple language, price of x good and demand of complementary good both are related negatively. If it is going to be increased, so demand of complementary good is going to decrease, like the example of bike and petrol. Okay, now third is income. Third we had learned about income. Okay, so income is also explained within two topic. First is normal good. What is normal good? Where we find positive relation between income and x good, there both are related positively, that is considered as a normal good. Okay, so in the case of normal good, if income is going to be increased, in response demand of normal good is going to be increased. Okay, for example, if your income is going to increase, you are going to use AC compartment या AC ticket more for traveling Gorakhpur to Lucknow. Okay, now if your income will decrease, so demand for normal good is going to be reduced. It's mean when your income decreases, so you are able to use less AC ticket. Okay, now take the exam. Second is inferior good. Suppose there are two good, x and y, and so in the case of inferior good, in the case of inferior good, if you talk about inferior good, so in the case of inferior good, if your income is going to increase, in response your demand for inferior good is going to decrease. Okay, so this negative relation, when we find this negative relation between demand of one good and income, then we are going to call it inferior good. Okay, so that we had learned. For example, if you take the example of a potato, या फिर यू कैन टेक द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ कोरस ग्रेन. द पीपल हु आर अर्निंग लेस इनकम, दे यूज कोरस ग्रेन, लाइक दे यूज राइस दैट इज़ अवेलेबल एट लो प्राइस. दे आर नॉट एबल टू यूज बासमती चावल. ओके, दे आर गोइंग टू यूज जो मोटा चावल होता है ना, वो उससे परचेज कर पाते हैं. ठीक है, तो जब आपकी इनकम इंक्रीज़ करेगी तो आप उसका कंजप्शन कम करके उसकी जगह क्या करते हो आप, अच्छी गुड को यूज़ करते हो, उसे रिप्लेस कर देते हो. ठीक है, ओके. नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज टेस्ट एंड प्रेफरेंस. सो इट इज़ अगेन गोइंग टू बी एक्सप्लेन अंडर टू कंडीशन फेवरेबल. इफ़ डिमांड फॉर अ गुड इज़ फेवरेबल, यानी कि यू लाइक दैट गुड, योर डिमांड, यू लाइक दैट गुड, यू वॉन्ट टू परचेज दैट गुड, इन दैट केस इट्स द डिमांड ऑफ दैट गुड, यानी दैट एक्स गुड इज़ गोइंग टू बी हाई लाइक एंड्रॉइड सेट. इफ द कंडीशन इज अनफेवरेबल, ना इट्स मीन वेन द गुड इज़ नॉट इन ट्रेंड, द गुड इज़ नॉट इन फैशन, सो यू आर गोइंग टू यूज़ इट लेस, लाइक की पैड फोन या फिर टाइप राइटर फॉर राइटिंग. ओके, नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज एक्सपेक्टेड. ओके, नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज एक्सपेक्टेड चेंज इन प्राइस. ओके, इफ यू फाइंड कि इन नियर फ्यूचर देयर विल बी शॉर्टेज ऑफ गुड, यानी कि प्राइस इज गोइंग टू बी हाई, सो इन दिस केस यू विल डिमांड मोर ऑफ एक्स गुड एट करेंट प्राइस. ओके स्टूडेंट, टेक द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ गोल्ड. इफ यू फील दैट कि इन नियर फ्यूचर गोल्ड इज गोइंग टू बी मोर एक्सपेंसिव, सो यू विल डिमांड मोर एट द प्रेजेंट प्राइस. ओके, या फिर देयर विल बी र्यूमर दैट कि देयर विल बी द शॉर्टेज ऑफ सम गुड एंड दैट बिकम मोर एक्सपेंसिव लाइक सैनिटाइजर, सो यू स्टार्टेड टू परचेज मोर ऑफ इट एट द करेंट प्राइस. ओके, सेम वे इफ यू फील कि सप्लाई ऑफ एक्स गुड इज गोइंग टू बी हाई इन नियर फ्यूचर. ओके, सो इन रिस्पॉन्स प्राइज इज गोइंग टू बी लेस. ओके, बिकॉज इट इज़ अवेलेबल इन मोर अमाउंट, तो प्राइज इज गोइंग टू बी लेस. इन रिस्पॉन्स प्रेजेंट डिमांड इज गोइंग टू बी लेस, बिकॉज यू फील दैट कि इन नियर फ्यूचर देयर विल बी द गुड इज अवेलेबल एट लीस्ट प्राइज, सो यू आर गोइंग टू डिमांड दैट गुड एट द प्रेजेंट टाइम इट्स लेस अमाउंट. ओके, लाइक इफ यू फील दैट कि द प्राइज ऑफ गोल्ड इज गोइंग टू बी लो इन नियर फ्यूचर, सो यू परचेज लेस ऑफ इट एट प्रेजेंट प्राइज. इफ यू कैन अवॉइड तो यू विल अवॉइड, यू विल वेट फॉर लोअरिंग द प्राइज. ओके स्टूडेंट, सो इन दिस वे योर इंडिविजुअल डिमांड फंक्शन हैड कम्प्लीटेड. नाउ इफ यू टॉक अबाउट मार्केट डिमांड फंक्शन, तो देर आर दीज फाइव एलिमेंट आर सेम, जस्ट देर आर न्यू टू डिटर्मिनेट्स. फर्स्ट इज नंबर ऑफ द बायर एंड सेकेंड इज डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ इनकम. सो लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड इट वन बाई वन. ओके, सो वॉट इज मार्केट डिमांड फंक्शन? सो मार्केट डिमांड फंक्शन, सो मार्केट डिमांड फंक्शन, सो मार्केट डिमांड ऑफ अ कमोडिटी इज रिलेटेड टू इट्स वेरियस डिटर्मिनेट, यानी कि एनी, इफ यू टेक द एग्जाम्पल दैट देयर इज अ एक्स कमोडिटी, सो इट्स मार्केट डिमांड. मैन मार्केट डिमांड मीन्स डिमांड बाई ऑल द बायर, तो डिमांड ऑफ ऑल द बायर फॉर द एक्स गुड इज गोइंग टू बी इन्फ्लुएंस्ड बाई वेरियस डिटर्मिनेट्स. वॉट आर दीज वेरियस डिटर्मिनेट्स? So these are the various determinants that is going to affect the demand of all the buyer. Okay, so here is all these five are the same as you had learned in individual demand function. Just there are two more. So you can see here population size are number of buyer and the next is distribution of income and price of its own price of related good income. Test and preference and expectation have already discussed in the case of individual demand function. Okay, so let we discuss these two new number of the buyer and distribution of income. Okay, so population size or number of buyer, which type of relation we find. Okay, let me understand it. So I'm going to explain it in my own language. Okay, student, suppose if number of buyer will increase ya phir population size will increase, so there will be if population size is going to be increased, it's mean there will be more buyers. Okay, so in result there will be more demand of X good. Okay, more demand of X good. Okay, student, for example, if you talk about 2001 census, so there are less population. If you talk about 2011, there are more population in India, so obviously demand of every type of good is going to be high. So when number of the people will increase, number of buyer will increase, and in response the demand of X is going to be more. Okay, student, so what is written in your book? So demand increases with the increase in the population and decreases with the decrease in population. This is because with increase in the population size, the number of the product tend to increase. Composition of population also affect the demand. If composition of population change, yani female population increase, demand for goods meant for women will go up. Okay, so I think these are the simple thing you are able to understand. Next is distribution of income. So let me understand in my own language first of all. So what is distribution of income? So when you talk about distribution of income, so it is always of two types. First is equitable. Okay, student, equitable distribution. So equitable distribution means there is equal distribution of national income, yani every people are having money to fulfill their basic requirement. So in this case, when there is equitable distribution of income, so demand of X good is going to be increased. So equitable, in the case of equitable distribution, demand of X is going to be increased. Okay, second condition is unequitable distribution of income. So in the case of unequal distribution of income, demand of X good is going to be low. Why? Because majority of the people is going to live below the poverty line, so they are not able to fulfill the basic requirement. So in this case, the demand of good is going to be low. Take the example of any underdeveloped or developed country. On the other hand, if you talk about the developed country, so obviously in developed country, standard of living of majority of people is high. Why? Because in that country, majority of the people are able to get this much amount of income that they can purchase basic commodities at market price. If you talk about underdeveloped or developing country, so a major portion of population, they are not able to get this much money, then they can themselves fulfill their basic requirement. What do you mean by basic requirement? So basic requirement means education, food, shelter. Okay, so these are known, sanitation, water, drinking water. So these are the basic requirement. Okay, so they are not able to fulfill the basic requirement themselves. Okay, so what is written in your book? Let me understand it. So market demand is also influenced by change in distribution of income. If income is equitable, there will be more demand. Okay, if not equitable, there will be less demand. In the latter case, केस, यानी कि इन द फर्स्ट व्हेन देयर इज इक्विटेबल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन, मोर इनकम विल कंसंट्रेट विद द रिच. ओके, यानी वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट, ओके वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट दिस वन व्हेन अनइक्विटेबल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन. ओके, वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट अनइक्वल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन. Largest section of the society will be the poor, and because of its low income, market demand will be low. Okay, student? Now, we are going to discuss next topic, and that is the topic of our today video. Okay? So, law of demand. What do you mean by the law of demand? So, first of all, I'm going to discuss about what do you mean by law of demand in my own language. Okay, student? So, what do you mean by law of demand? So, okay. I had told you about market demand function. The market demand of X good is the function of PX, yani price of own, price of related good, income, taste and preference, expected change in price, number of buyer, and distribution of income. Okay, distribution of income. So these are the factors that influence the demand of X good. Okay, market demand of X good. When we are discussing law of demand, so what do you mean by law of demand? So it is going to explain the relationship between demand of X. Demand of X is depend upon price of X, keeping other factor constant. Yani ki, when we are going to discuss law of demand, so here we are going to make the relationship between these two. We are going to study when there is increase or decrease in the price of X good, how it is going to affect its demand. So, keeping other factor constant. So, this relation is law of demand. Which type of relation we find? We find negative relation. Price of its own and demand of that good, we find negative relation. Okay? Okay. So, when we are discussing the law of demand, we are going to explain this one. The demand of X good is depend upon its own price, and there is negative relation. It's mean when price of X is going to be high, in response demand of X good is going to be low. On the other hand, if price of X good is going to be low, then demand of X good is going to be high. Take the example of air conditioner. AC, you take the example of AC. If you go to the 10 or 15 year back, so there is not room AC, that is not in that much trend. Okay, so people are using window AC, so that is very costly. Its price is went to 2 lakh. Okay, so majority of the people are not able to purchase it. Okay, so mostly it is used in used by the businessman ya fir business unit, hospitals, yani big business houses, okay, and very rich people. But because of room AC and new technology, its price has decreases. Now it is available even 35,000, at the price of 35,000. It is available on installment also. So you now in today's scenario, in you find majority of the house is having AC, okay, at least in one room. So this is what, when price of AC is too high, so there are less consumer. Okay, few families yeah, few houses are able to purchase it. When now when price of AC is low, majority of the people are using AC. Okay, so this is what, this is your law of demand. So one thing is that keeping other factor constant. Constant means there will be no change. तो व्हाट आर द अदर फैक्टर, यानी प्राइस ऑफ रिलेटेड गुड, इनकम, टेस्ट एंड प्रेफरेंस, एक्सपेक्टेड चेंज इन प्राइस, नंबर ऑफ द बायर, डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ इनकम, ऑल दीज डिटर्मिनेंट्स, देयर विल बी नो चेंज. दीज डिटर्मिनेंट इज गोइंग टू बी कॉन्स्टेंट. देयर विल बी ओनली वन थिंग दैट इज गोइंग टू बी चेंज, दैट इज प्राइस ऑफ इनकम. सो इन दिस केस व्हेन प्राइस ऑफ रिलेटेड गुड, इनकम, टेस्ट एंड प्रेफरेंस, एक्सपेक्टेड चेंज इन प्राइस, नंबर ऑफ द बायर, डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ इनकम, व्हेन ऑल दीज फैक्टर आर कॉन्स्टेंट, इन दिस केस व्हेन प्राइस इज गोइंग टू बी हाई, इन रिस्पॉन्स डिमांड इज गोइंग टू बी लो. व्हेन प्राइस इज गोइंग टू बी लो, डिमांड इज गोइंग टू बी हाई. यू कैन टेक द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ एंड्रॉयड सेट. इनिशियली देयर आर ओनली फ्यू ब्रांड, ओके, एंड द प्राइस ऑफ एंड्रॉयड सेट इज टू हाई, सो इट इज यूज्ड बाय ओनली फ्यू पीपल. बट टुडे the rate of androids is very low and in compared to initial time, and there are lot of brand also available, so you can find that ki majority of the people are using android set. So I think now this is clear. What do you mean by law of demand? Okay, so let we understand with the help of the book. Okay, so law of demand state that other things keeping constant. What do you mean by other things being constant? Yani ki price of related good, income, test and preference, expected change in price, number of buyer, distribution of income. So all these factor is going to be constant. Okay, there will be no change. So in this case, quantity demanded increase with increase decrease in own price, okay, vice versa. Yani ki price is going to be high, so demand of x is going to be low when all these factor is constant, okay. So there is which type of relation we find, yani ki demand of x is the function of px and there is negative relation, okay. So that is written here, there is inverse means negative, both are changing in opposite direction, okay. So there is inverse relation between quantity demanded of a commodity and its own price, other things remaining constant. Other things means price of related, income, test and preference, expected change in price, number of the buyer and distribution of income. The term other things being equal implies all other determinants of demand, okay, beside the price, okay. So in simple, in the last line it is given what is demand. So law of demand state that other things remaining constant, there is inverse relationship between quantity demanded and own price of commodity, okay. Now why are goods demanded? Why we use goods? Because goods are having utility. Already in the second chapter I had told you ki each and every good that is available in this earth having utility. Even alcohol and drugs, these are also having highly utility. Why? Because the addictor find high utility, high level of satisfaction when they are going to consume it. So in the economics, every good is going to be utility. In this way, every commodity is going to satisfy a particular want, okay. So we demand a good because every good is able to satisfy particular want. So that is why we demand a good. If you want to write whatever I'm teaching, so you require what? You require pen or pencil. So in this way, pen or pencil is going to be demanded by you, okay, when you are learning. If you are going to outside, you are going to party, so that time you require party dresses, and according to that all the accessories, so you are going to demand for that, okay. Now it is a tabular presentation of law of demand, okay. Here you can see when price is 10 rupees, then demand is 100 rupees. Now when price decreases, it become 9, so demand is going to be 150. Now price decreases more, it become 8 rupees. That time demand is going to be 200. So in this way we find which type of relation, negative. Why we are saying negative or inverse relation? Because price and demand are changing in opposite direction. When it is decreasing, it is increasing. So that is why we are denoting it with inverse relation. Okay, so that is written here. Okay, when 100 to 150, when price is reduces from 10 to 9. Okay, it is demanded from 150 to 200, when price reduced from 9 to 8. So which type of relation we find? We find negative relation. Now it's a diagrammatic presentation. Okay, student. So here we can see that ki when price is OP, when price is OP, what is demand? Demand is OQ. Okay, when price decrease, when price is OP, this is price of X good, that time what is demand of X good? That is OQ. Now price is decreases and it become P1. So in this case, demand of X good increase and it become OQ1. So here you can, when price decreases from OP1, so demand increase from OQ to OQ1. So this is the increase in demand. So when price fall from OP to OP1, so demand increases from OQ to OQ1. Okay, so we find negative relation. So this is the diagrammatic presentation of demand curve. Okay, now assumptions of law of demand. So when we are going to talk about assumptions of law of demand, so you had learned na ki demand of, sorry, we had learned that demand of X is the function of PX, PR yani price of related good, income, test and preference, expected change in price, number of buyer and distribution of income. Okay, so here just one thing is going to worry, that is what? Price of its own and all other yani price of related, income, test, expected change, number of buyer and distribution of income, all these are going to be constant. All these are thing going to be constant, yani there will be no change. So how you are going to write it? Assumptions of law of demand. So there is no change in price of related good, there is no change in income, there will be no change in test and preference, there will be no change in expectation of buyer, there will be no change in number of buyer, there will be no change in distribution of income. Okay student, so here you can see all these things. There will be test and preference of consumer is constant, no change in income, related good no change, consumer do not expect any significant change in availability of good in near future. So this is what, this is your assumption of demand. Now why other factor are kept constant? So when we are going to learn law of demand, okay, so what we are going to discuss here, how demand of X is going to depend upon price of X, that we are going to discuss here. So how we find, which type of relation we find? We find negative relation. Okay, we find negative relation. But when other things, yani ki price of related, income, test and preference, expected change in price, number of buyer and distribution of income, all these things is going to be constant, there will be no change in these factors. So why we are going to keep these factor constant? So here is given the reason, because we want to understand the separate influence of one factor, so it is necessary that we are going to keep other factor constant. Okay, so that is the reason. Now here we are going to discuss why this law of demand we find. What is the reason for having downward sloping demand curve? So first reason is here written, law of diminishing marginal utility. But I'm going to explain first of all in my own way. So when you are learning law of demand, okay? So when you are learning law of demand, the first reason is because of law of diminishing marginal utility. So I had told you that ki in case of one good, when we find consumer equilibrium, so consumer equilibrium we will get when price of X in terms of rupee is going to be equal to marginal utility of X in terms of rupee. So where this condition is going to be satisfied, that point is considered as a consumer equilibrium. Suppose I'm paying 5 rupees, okay, and I'm going 5 rupees utility. So this is the condition of consumer equilibrium. Now suppose the price of X is going to be high, it becomes 7 rupees, and how much utility I'm getting from this X good? 5 rupee. Okay, so in this way I'm paying more and getting less satisfaction. You know, na price is going to denote sacrifice, and on the other hand utility is going to denote satisfaction. So which is greater? Sacrifice is greater. So obviously in this condition you are going to reduce consumption of X good. So in this way, because of law of diminishing marginal utility, we find negative relation. Okay student, so let me understand what is written in your book. According to this law, as commodity, consumption of a commodity increase, marginal utility derived from each successive unit goes on diminishing. Accordingly, for every additional unit to be purchased, the consumer is willing to pay less and less price. Okay? Now, next reason for having law of demand is income effect. So, in my own language, first of all, income effect. Okay. Now suppose ki you are having, okay, you are having 20 rupees, okay, and there is Maggi, packet of Maggi that is available 10 rupee per unit, okay, price of Maggi is 10 rupee per unit. In this case you are able to purchase 2 Maggi, you are able to purchase 2 Maggi, okay. Now if suppose price of Maggi is going to decrease, is become 5 rupees per unit, in this case you are able to purchase 4 Maggi. So in this way there is no change in the price, but when price reduces it will increase purchasing power of a consumer. So there will be increase in the purchasing power of a consumer, because of that he is able to purchase more. Okay, now what is written in your book? So income effect refers to effect on a commodity when real income, yani ki purchasing, real income means purchasing power, okay, of buyer change because of change in price of commodity. When price fall, the real purchasing income, yani ki purchasing power, is going to increase, okay. Accordingly, demand for the commodity is going to be expand. Like in that example, you are having the same 20 rupees, but when price is 10, you are able to purchase 2 Maggi. When price is 5 rupees per unit of the same Maggi, so you are able to purchase 4 Maggi, okay. So there is no change in your income, but because of fall in the income, you are able to purchase more Maggi, okay. Now नेक्स्ट इज सब्स्टिट्यूशन इफेक्ट. तो लेट वी अंडरस्टैंड इट. ओके, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय सब्स्टिट्यूट गुड. सब्स्टिट्यूट गुड्स मीन्स दैट कैन बी व्हेन देयर आर टू गुड एक्स एंड वाई. व्हेन देयर आर टू गुड एक्स एंड वाई इन दिस केस when goods are used in place of each other, yani we can use x in place of y and y in place of x, so this is known as a substitute good. Okay, so suppose price of x is 10 rupee per unit, price of y is suppose 20 rupees per unit. Okay, if you are having 40, your income is 40, yani you are having 40 rupees in your pocket. Okay, so you can purchase 4x, and if you want to purchase y only, so you can purchase 2y. Okay, now suppose ki price of y increase and it become 40 rupees per unit. Now how much you can purchase? So in this case, when price become 40 rupees per unit, so obviously you are like to purchase x good in place of y good. So in this way, with the same 40 rupees, now you are going to purchase 4x. When you are purchasing 2y, okay, now because of price has reduced, so you are going to, in before condition, you like to purchase price of, you like to purchase y good. Why? Because there is not too much difference in the price of both the good, and you like y good more. Y suppose coffee and x is suppose tea. So there are many people who like to drink coffee. So in this case, you are purchasing coffee because you are getting 2 packet of coffee. But suppose the price of coffee become more costly, per packet you require to pay 40 rupees. So in this case, you are able to purchase only 1 packet of coffee. That is not sufficient for you. So now you are going to substitute it with tea. Okay, and in this case, how much packet of tea you are able to get? You are able to get 4 packet of coffee. One more example I can give you for its explanation. Suppose there is Coca-Cola and one side is Pepsi. Okay, it is also 10 rupee per unit. It is also 10 rupees per unit. Okay, now you are having 60 rupees. Your income is 60 rupees. Okay, now this is the one case. Now suppose Pepsi has increased its price and it is now available 12 rupees per bottle. So both are having the same taste, same flavor. So it doesn't matter ki you are going to drink Pepsi or you are going to drink Coca-Cola. So in this case, when price of Pepsi is going to be high and you are having 60 rupees, if suppose you are going to purchase Pepsi, so how much unit you are able to purchase Pepsi? 5. But if you are going to use this money on Coca-Cola, so you are able to purchase 6 Coca-Cola. So obviously any rational consumer is going to opt this option. Why? Because you are getting 6 bottle of Coca-Cola. Okay, so there is no change in the price of Coca-Cola, but you had substituted Pepsi. Now you are using Coca-Cola. Why? Because Pepsi has become relatively high. Okay, and Coca-Cola has become relatively less. Costly. Okay, now next is article of distinction. Now we are going to learn about exception of law of demand. So this is exception of law of demand. So first is article of distinction. So what is article of distinction? Yani ki the goods which we use as a social status ya social symbol. हम वो गुड जिसको हम इसलिए यूज़ करते हैं क्योंकि हमें किसी से बोलना नहीं पड़ता कि आई एम हैविंग टू मच मनी या आई एम बिलोंगिंग टू अ वेरी हाई क्लास फैमिली. लाइक यू कैन टेक द एग्जांपल ऑफ पार्कर पेन. पेन इज़ पेन. if your writing is good, you are going to write with the jitter, or you are going to write with the Parker pen, your writing is going to be same. But you are, if a person is using Parker pen, why he is using Parker pen? Why? Because it is a status symbol. Like Amitabh Bachchan, he used Parker pen. Okay, why? Because it is a status symbol. Same way, if you talk about the Pulsar bike, if you talk about the Mercedes car, car is car, but it is a status symbol. If one side a person is coming out from the Honda City and one other person is coming out from the Mercedes, so obviously you are able to say ki B is more rich because he is coming out from Mercedes. Okay, so in this way, these are the goods. Exception of law of demand, we are discussing exception of law of demand. The exception means where law of demand is not applicable. Okay, so where law of demand is going to be failed. The first is what? Article of distinction, yani ki social status, social symbol good, like diamond, luxurious good. Okay, so we purchase only it because it is a status symbol. So here law of demand is not applicable. Next is Giffen goods. So Giffen goods are what? It is very higher inferior good. When its price is high, we are going to purchase more. Why? Because we are not having sufficient money to purchase anything else. Like take the example of poor people. If a person is earning only 20 rupees in a day, so he is not able to purchase green vegetable. In that case, he is only able to purchase potato. So in this case, potato is what? Potato is inferior good. Okay, suppose if price of potato is going to be less, it become 5 rupee per kg. So now if you talk about that day only, so if he will purchase 1 kg potato, so now he can use 15 rupees on other any on green vegetable. Okay, but if take the another example, in that case, if suppose price of potato is now it become 40 rupees per kg and he is earning only 20 rupees, in this case he is able to only purchase half kg. So in this case he is going to only purchase potato. So in the case of Giffen good, when price is high, we purchase it more. Okay, we are going to cut consumption on other good and we are going to purchase staple or basic thing. Okay, so this is your Giffen good. What is written here? So it is very highly inferior good, very high negative income effect. As a result, when price of such commodity falls, their demand also falls, and when price is high, their demand is high. This is known as a Giffen paradox. Okay, student. Now, irrational judgment. There are many people who feel that ki when price is high, the quality of a good is going to be good. So they purchase a good because price is high, so obviously quality is also is going to be better. So this is a irrational judgment. So there are many people. Okay, so for example, here is given law of demand fails when consumer judge the quality of a good by its price. It is an irrational judgment. Perhaps it is owing to huge price difference between organic and non-organic product in the market. Richest section of the society consider organic product of very high quality. Accordingly, quantity demanded of these product has tend to rise even when the price are extremely high. Okay, now when this law of demand fail, yani in the case of exception, which type of demand curve we find? We find upward sloping law of demand. Okay, why? Because there is positive relation. Price of X is the function of demand. In this case, demand of X is the function of PX and we find positive relation. So when price is OP1, demand is OQ. When price increases, it become OP1, demand also increases and it become OQ2. So when we join these two prime, we get a line and that is going to be upward sloping. Okay, why? Because there is positive relation. Thank you.